It is November 21st, obviously moving our Team Simply Beautiful call to Monday by popular, or actually by request. I was going to cancel it this week so everybody could enjoy time with their families, but honestly, I think that it was freaking badass that everybody wanted to still come on and connect this week. So I'm going to ask a question, okay? And I want to know completely honest answer, okay? Like, everybody here has to be very, very honest with me. There's no wrong answer to this. If you are feeling a little bit overwhelmed in your business right now, I want you to raise your hand. Okay. Okay. Now, what we're going to do is I want everybody to stand up. Stand up, everybody with me. I'm going to play a song and we're all going to dance. Ready? Everybody dance. Get out of your system. Come on. Get those tacky clothes coming along. The sky's blue. Cannonball into the pool. Drinking and going at the pool. Like sha-la-la. Love this song. I was playing that third eye blind. Wife is sipping that rosé wine. I just lost all track of time. Like sha-la-la. All right. Get to the chorus. Let's go. My truck AC is broken. That Georgia breeze blowing. I'm feeling he's going. That's right. I feel good today. Can't nobody bring me down. And I just got paid. And I think I'm gonna hit the town. Feel my problems can wait tomorrow. Cause I feel good today. Yeah. Can't nobody bring me down. Can't nobody bring me down. All right, everybody feel a little bit better? All right. That shit's gonna go viral when I post that later. Just kidding. But okay, does everybody feel a little bit better? Everybody has a smile on their face right now. And that's how I wanted to start this call, because I wanted to bring us back to the beginning. Because when I first started as a coach, that was the feeling that I had. The feeling where I was so excited to be here every single day and out of breath, because I loved what I was doing. I loved my job so much. I got to help people. And every single time that I helped somebody, I wanted to dance and run around my room and scream. And what we just did as a team together is remember what that feeling was like, right? We got to smile and we got to dance and we got to have fun, because that's what this business is fun. There's going to be times where it's going to be a little stressful. People are going to tell you no. All the things that you think can go wrong are going to go wrong. We have these giant goals that are coming up and we're stressed and we're thinking about all the reasons, like, why we can't miss this goal. And all of a sudden, we find ourselves where we don't want to be in this business, overwhelmed and stressed. And I found myself there many times throughout these past 2.5 years. So if you guys are new, and I know a lot of you are new, a lot of you, when I say new, I mean like started in the past 6 months. There's going to be ebbs and flows in this business, but every single time that you are feeling upset, I'm going to be posting this video, and I'm going to give you that song, and you're going to dance every single time. Because no matter what, we are a team, and we are here because we love each other, because we support each other, and because we're about to make some big shit happen together by changing the lives of other people. So I want you guys to post one word in that just chat box. How did that one moment right there make you feel? Getting up, I literally was watching you guys and happy, free, alive, happy, joyful, fan-freaking-tastic. This stuff is like, and what, and then also, relax, awesome, happy. Seeing your teammates doing the same thing and having fun, how did that make you feel? connected, ecstatic. I love these words. Blessed, happy. Holy shit, we can take on the world together. That gave me goosebumps, like part of a family, made me laugh, like a family, excited. So what we just did, that feeling that you had when you were dancing, is the feeling that you guys had when you had your first transformation, right? That feeling that you had when you looked in the mirror at yourself for the first time and you loved what you saw. That second word you described is that moment you were able to give it to somebody else. You got to see them be happy. And you got to see them dance and see them be carefree. And see, I had to take you guys in the bathroom with me, Ashen. But these words that you guys said, connection, family, it made you laugh. You can take on the world together, happy, blessed, ecstatic. Guys, you described what coaching should be. The words overwhelmed, depressed, nervous, scared, frustrated. I don't want those words in our vocabulary. And there's going to be times where this life is going to test you and this business is going to test you and it is going to make you so mad. If you guys have not experienced it already, right? But the cool thing is that we have each other no matter what. These little boxes to your left, to your right, below you, above you, that's your family. We are connected. You guys may never have met these people in your lives, but I can look at every single one of you, no matter how long you've been in this business, and know that together we're making waves. I heard this great quote once where it was like, well, if you take a pebble, like one person, you take a pebble and you throw it into the water, and it'll just make a tiny little splash, right? But if you take this giant boulder, what's going to happen when you throw it in the water? It's going to create waves. You alone are that tiny little pebble. But we together are this giant boulder. So when life gets tough, when people tell you no, when you get a cancellation email, when somebody says they're going to do something, they don't follow through with it, you have two options. You're going to sit back and be frustrated, or you're going to look out and find somebody else that gives you the feeling that you felt when you watched your teammates dance. Because you can give that to somebody. Could you guys imagine if we got on the call with one of our challenge, every single one of our challengers after they got their first transformation and we played that song? Dancing together. Like, that's the kind of feeling that I have whenever somebody sends me a transformation. I'm so guilty of this. And I came onto this call tonight. I didn't have a topic. I didn't know what I wanted to say to you guys tonight because I was feeling uninspired myself. I was so caught up in everything that was happening in my business right now. And it's the end of the year. And guys, believe it or not, people tell me no to. I haven't had anybody sign up in a week. And I know that this is temporary because I'm doing everything I can. But it does weigh on you. Hearing no's all the time, it weighs on you. But every single time somebody says yes, I forget about every single one of those no's. Every single one. Tonight, getting on my first call with the girls that are pushing for Elite right now, seeing what's about to happen, what you guys are about to experience, what you guys are about to see. Like, I came into today with like a pit in my stomach thinking like, what if this didn't happen? What if I just did this whole year and this didn't happen? What could I, and then I play the me card where I'm like, what did I not do correctly? Did I not do something right? Because I'm sitting here and instead of not having the faith, I'm getting trapped into that feeling that you guys felt right before you started dancing. I'm getting myself trapped into this thing thinking, why me, why me, why me, instead of finding the solution to my issue. And honestly, the solution is right here. It's mindset. If I really, really, really wanted to go out and help somebody tonight, you better bet your ass I'm not sleeping until I do it. Right? When we really, really want something, think about what, post in the chat box, what is the last thing you, not in this business, but in life, okay? What is something, the last thing you really, really wanted? Like you really wanted to happen, or you really wanted to do, or you really wanted to go on vacation to, or whatever. What's something you wanted really, really bad? It can be small, it can be big. There's no wrong or right answer here. My new bed. Getting engaged. Yes, I can. We can count that. Passing inspection for work. That's a great example. Getting engaged. So getting, paying off bills. That's a great example. Okay. Something you wanted really bad. Having a baby. Love that. Saying goodbye to Penn State's debt. Would you guys do, for those things you just said, if I was standing inside of a burning building and I had it in my hand and I said, give it, you can come get this and you have what you want. Would you run in after that? Right? So if you really, really wanted to hit Emerald, if you really, really, really wanted to hit Success Club, if you really, really, really wanted to hit Diamond, if you really, really, really wanted to bring on a new coach, if you really, really, really wanted to lose 50 pounds, think of me in that burning building holding it, dancing to the song we danced to at the beginning of this call. Because guess what? When you want something bad enough, you won't stop until you get it. You won't. I don't know if you guys had a chance to watch that video that I posted on our team page last night. I made a video for my family on November 18th, 2015. And I completely forgot about it until last night. I went on YouTube and I was scrolling through my channel, so I was looking for an old video and I scrolled past it and I clicked on it. A video that I didn't know how to tell my family that I was gonna quit my job. And I'm so grateful to this day that I made that video, because it was really cool to go watch it again a year later. I tell my family that I'm gonna leave my job because I was tired. I looked at myself and saw bags under my eyes. I could see how miserable I was, but I could also see how full of hope that I was. I could hear it in my voice, knowing that I was finally doing something for myself, that I wanted it so bad that I was going to do whatever I could to make it happen for myself. I came into 2016. How many of you guys are aware of my story, other than like what you see off of social media? So I'm not going to go into too much detail on that. But at that time in my life, I knew that I needed to make this work. How many of you here need to make this work? Whether it be for extra money every month, whether it be to pay for your Shakeology, whatever it is, you know that you just need to make this work, right? I knew that I needed to make this work. So I stopped looking at all the shiny things that came along with the business. Whenever I was sitting there making that video on November 18th, 2015, I wasn't thinking about Elite. I wasn't thinking about 5-star Diamond. I wasn't thinking about 2-star Diamond. I wasn't thinking about Emerald. I wasn't thinking about any of that stuff. What I was thinking about is how bad I needed this to happen for myself. And how I knew, I just knew that if I could show up and keep my head down, not look left, not look right, not compare myself to any other coach, because I started at the same time as so many six-figure earners now. And I'm not a six-figure earner. I'm nowhere close. And I was sitting back for the longest time just comparing myself, especially to my upline coach. But when I made that video, my focus was solely on the fact that I needed to do whatever I could to make this happen for myself. Because that, like leaving that job, was basically somebody in the burning building asking me to run in for it. that was how bad I wanted it. So my coach said, Kelsey, make sure that you stabilize that diamond account. I came into 2016 pretty much an emerald coach. I was diamond by thread, meaning that I had a coach on my left leg who was projected to lose both of her people. So her emerald was falling apart. I was making $200 a week, maybe a little less sometimes. And I was needing to cover my Shakeology as well as now pay for my wedding that was coming up, as well as pay my student loans, as well as all this other stuff that was piling up. And it did, on paper, it did not look smart. I will say that. But for me, I knew how bad I needed this to happen. I told my coach my why. All that stuff you just posted. I told my coach that stuff, and she would not let me fail. She would not let me back down. When I told her, like, hey, I literally called her, I think toward the end of that month after I made that video, and I was like, I don't know if I should do this. And she literally yelled at me on the phone. She goes, you are quitting that damn job because you told me that you needed to. I want to show you guys this stuff because I feel like a lot of times we don't look at like the people that are farther along in the business as somebody that has been there where you guys are sitting right now. I was a coach back in NAM, okay? This was my Emerald certificate. Look how big it is, okay? I hit Emerald on May 1st, 2014. And getting this in the mail was so cool. It meant that I helped my first two people. And I don't know, just like getting the letter from Carl Deichler and we had pins back then. That's how I said I was like the coach at NAM. We didn't get the bracelets, we got the pins. That was freaking phenomenal. That was so cool. And then I get these ones. I move my business forward and get diamond, and then one star, and then two star. And all of it came with a lot of hard work. Every single one of these certificates I look at, and I remember that time period. This one most importantly, because this one was the one where I proved myself I could do it. It was the first two people. The first two transformations. And I said, if I can help two people, I know I can quit my job. The logic might not seem completely right there, but I knew I could do it. There's a lot of stuff that I've dealt with over the past couple of years. like you guys all know, I mean, I've told you this multiple times, but none of you were here. Alicia was here at this time last year. That was it. Alicia Van Snyder. She was the only one that was here, and she didn't go really like full force with the business until the next year. She was new. She didn't know what she was working for yet, and that's okay. But like I said, I came into this year, and I had none of you. I knew none of you. I didn't know where I was going with this, but I just knew that I wanted to make something of myself. I knew that I had to prove to myself that I could do it. And I remember right before I quit, Zach and I sat down and we were talking about finances and all this different stuff. And Zach goes, I need to be honest with you. Like, if you can't make this work, like by March, like you're going to have to go back. So I want you guys to imagine if Rebecca, if you said Beachbody getting into grad school, if somebody told you, well, you have to give that back if you don't make this work. If making it through my first evaluation with a new boss, like that's when you're gonna take that back, or all like, you get it and then you get it back, you have to take it back or get it back. Think about that. If somebody that like Martha, she wants to go to do a match, her why is to get to a match in Germany. So what if you got there and somebody says, well, if you don't make this work, you gotta come back. You get that like taste on your tongue, right? You get that taste on your tongue of like what this could be for yourself. Then somebody tells you like, Well, if it doesn't work, you have to go back to that, what you don't want. Would that make you guys work a little harder? I put my head down that month and I worked a lot in January and February. And in March, we were sitting on the cruise ship, the beach, but we are in through Beachbody. And on my Coach Online office, I pulled it up to see that my paycheck that week matched my 2 weeks, 2 weeks in Beachbody matched my 2 week at my corporate. And I remember looking at Zach and I was like, I'm never going back to corporate. So, but that was it. All you guys need is somebody telling you that you can't and a reason big enough on why you can't. These things are, this business is, like I said, there's so many ebbs and flows and we get so sidetracked by all the stuff that we can't control. But one thing you guys can control is your daily actions and what you do. And like I said, this thing is we get so sidetracked on all the shiny things in this business, but like maybe it's time that we all take a deep breath. Like do it right now. Take a deep breath. Remember why you're here and go for it. You don't need a perfect post. You don't need the perfect words. You just need to be you. You need to be yourself. And guys, I know that a lot of you are dealing with the holiday no's right now. I know you are. Because I've been in this business for 2 years and this is my third holiday season and I know exactly what it's like. But how many of you guys can remember previous Thanksgivings where you were leaving Thanksgiving and you felt like shit about yourself? Anybody? You were sitting there and you ate from the moment you walked in the door to the moment you left. Everybody recognize that feeling? You know how many people are going to have that feeling this Thursday? You know how many people are going to log onto your Facebook page and see that you did your workout that morning and they're going to hate you for a quick second? The next morning you're going to wake up and you're still doing it and you go shopping. You don't even have to wear your leggings because you still fit in your jeans. People think that they don't need us right now. They need you. We don't need to go for perfect because no one wants a perfect coach. And I say this on every single coach opportunity call I ever do is no one wants a perfect coach. They want you in your rawest form. And right now we have the opportunity to get people. We have the opportunity to get people started like right before, like, and get them started right after Thanksgiving. We have a huge 3.5 week gap before Christmas. Next Monday is a great 21 day fix starting group. Like honestly, because they're done on December 17th. Ends right before Christmas. So my advice tonight, and I don't want to keep you guys too long because this is not our normal time. And if anybody has any questions or any thoughts, please post them in the comment section. But my hope for you guys tonight is that you remember that moment at the beginning of this call. You remember how free you felt, how excited you were, how much like you were just ready to like take on the world after that, right? Everybody felt good. Everybody was smiling. Everybody was pumped up. I want you guys to take that energy and I want you guys to pass that on to somebody tonight. Share with them what this has done for you and whatever that goal is that's in the back of your mind that you're shooting for, don't you dare stop until you make it happen because you want it, right? You want it so bad. Like close your eyes and think about what it would feel like to make it happen. What would that feeling be like if you woke up on Thursday morning as a diamond coach, as an emerald coach? What would that feeling be like when somebody calls you and tells you that they're down 20 pounds? What would that feeling be like when you get shouted out on Team Page by your coach? or you get that package in the mail from your upline because you accomplished that goal and you had no idea it was coming, or you're, this was like my, I think my most, one of my favorite moments is like hearing I'm proud of you from your significant other. What's that going to feel like? Because honestly, that's a feeling you don't want to lose. That's a feeling worth fighting for. And tonight, as we head into the next couple of days, I ask that you guys don't look at this as a stressful thing. Remember why you came into this. Remember what those first couple of days were like whenever you were like, ooh, this is exciting. People are interested in what I have to offer. This is cool. Go back to that. Because somewhere along the way, we lose that. We lose what this whole thing is really about. And honestly, it's just about helping people. It's about helping people and helping each other. And remembering that no matter what, like, we're always going to be here for each other. And I don't ever, and I think that's why it's so hard for me when people quit. Because I don't know how you guys can, how people can walk away from what we have and what we accomplished together as a team. So if you're a new coach and you're on this call right now, very new coach, I want to tell you guys this, that this season that you're in, this holiday season, this Thanksgiving or November, December, it's a season of push. I talked about this last week. You have to do a little extra. But I promise you, your hard work is going to pay off tenfold come January. You might have to push a little bit harder right now, just right now. But I promise you, the reward is coming. You might help 2 to 3 people this month. You might just hit Success Club 6. But I remember very, very, very like strongly hitting like Success Club 6 and then the next month hitting like Success Club 14 in January. And then like 20. And then like 24. Because I was doing the work that other people weren't doing. This is a season where everybody else steps back. Because they don't remember why they're here. And the fact that it's a Monday night and there are 18 of you spending your time with me means that there's something that you guys are fighting for. There's something that this business can do for you and you know it can do for you. So I'm going to answer Kristen's question really quick. Kristen asked, for those watching the recording, I watched your video about having genuine conversations and not bringing up Beachbody right away, but I've been having a lot of great conversations that haven't led to Beachbody. How do I address that? It seems like when I'm bringing up Beachbody challenge groups, when I was recruited from November challenge group, the same bad response. Yes. Okay. So great question. With what you're doing, I typically, I just kind of have conversations for a while. I keep going with them with zero intention. And what I do is I do most of my inviting work via my social media page. So like if I post, if I'm having these behind the scenes conversations that are just not about Beachbody, that's okay. Like, right. We're still making a new friend. But what I'll do is I'm adding value on my social media page. So the moment that those people like a post of mine about Beachbody, I feel like I can transition into it. It's not like there's something out there like where I've never spoken to them before and like I'm like, oh, hey, join my challenge group. It's more of like you're saying right now, it sounds like you're just talking, right? You're just catching up. You're getting to know each other. Well, Facebook has an algorithm now where it sees that you've connected with that person. So now your stuff is showing up in their newsfeed all the time, like a lot. So if you put up like a group thing, like you're looking for people to join you for a 21-day fix group coming up, and that person that you're having a conversation with just likes it, that's your open end to invite them to your challenge group. Other people do it differently. That's the way that I do it because I just want to go into it with people knowing that like I genuinely want to have a conversation with them. Other ways I do it is people, if I'm just having a conversation and people ask what I do for a living. Oh, I'm actually an online health and fitness coach. I help people get results, blah, blah, blah. What do you do? And I just kind of like bring it up like in conversation and people always come back to that too. But yeah, I think just like continuing what you're doing, I wouldn't just like, people will know if you're like talking about the kids and all of a sudden you're like, so have you heard of Beachbody? Like, it's just, it's weird, you know? And like, you know that it feels weird doing it and it's weird being on the receiving end of that. So I think that like, if you're being consistent on the social media side of things, I really do believe that like, that'll be your way in to invite them to that group too. Does that make sense? Does that help? So we're bringing Beachbody up right away. Like, I feel like my post. Yes, I do. Like, see, last night, for instance, this is the perfect example. Last night, I put up a challenge group post. So a lot of people on there I actually haven't talked to before, or at least we haven't talked to since like February or January that liked the post. I straight up invited them because they liked to group. They liked to post about Beachbody. Like, it was not like, and this is exactly what I said, because I actually have it written down, because I did voice messages. Hey girl, thanks so much for the love and feedback on my 21 days of fitness post. Not sure if it's something that you're interested in, but wanted to reach out and personally invite you. This is the time of year where people put fitness on the back burner, so I put it together a little group where we can all push together in the next 3 weeks. It's, I don't know if you've heard of it before, but it's a 21 day fix, and we're pairing it with Shakeology. It's a program based on nutrition, portion control, and more. We're all dialing in together and pushing for a transformation, and I would love for you to join us. Let me know if you want more information, blah, 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 something like that. Obviously I say it more conversationally. I don't like read it right off of here. I'm just like, hey, long time no talk, blah, blah, blah. And I'm like making it more personal. But yeah, if they like a Beachbody post, like, think about it this way. If you liked somebody's LuLaRoe post, would you be shocked if they reached out and asked you to come to their party? So it's the same thing. Like, they like to post about you doing your workout. They like to post about you, your meal plan, something like that. Like, that's, I mean, to me, that's your in. I'm not the kind of girl that will just, like, message somebody. Like, if I've never spoken to this person before, I'm probably not going to, I'll start, like, being conversational at first. But, like, these people here, I messaged 14 people today. Our conversations were back in, like, December, January, February, and I just straight up invited them again. Does that help? I've been running into the same people like my post all the time now, so I've been trying to branch out more to beat the algorithm. Yeah, and then with that, just keep going through your newsfeed and starting to like and comment on just other people's stuff. The more that you go out and like and comment on other people's things, the more they'll be tracked back to you also. And then as you add new people to your network, message them and introduce yourself. That's another way to get more people liking on your post too. If you ever get to that, guys, if you ever get to a lull where you're just like, it's the same people all the time, you just have to just, like, I go into my friends list, and I just start, like, going into people's stuff, find people that I have stuff in common with or something that I'm interested in, and I'll just start liking, and I comment on their stuff. And I'm like, oh, my gosh, your kid's so cute. And it's not like you're being fake. Like, their kid is cute. Like, their dog is cute. Like, you are happy for them to be engaged. Like, so it's, like, just be yourself, you know? It's just a way to branch yourself out a little more. And as a new coach, that's the most common things you're going to run into. It's the same people all the time and stuff like that. Beth said, I started a game with myself after I mess with someone. I look at friends in common, and then I pick one of their friends in common and pick one. And so, yeah, that's a great way of doing it too. Guys, there's a tab. If you go to somebody, like one of your friends, there's a tab in their friends list that says mutual friends. Like, I can show you guys if you've never seen this before. I'll use like one of my coaches, for instance. Let me see if I can. No, she's not a good one to use. This is not a good one to use. Hold on, I'm trying to find somebody that like shares them. All of you freaking hiding your friends from me. You all know my tactics. Okay, Erica's works. Okay, so if you guys go to like their page and you click on more people you may know. Like, I can go through there and, like, click on her friends and, like all of her people or her people like this. So, like, if Erica signed up with me as a challenge group, I could be like, okay, I'm going to add Allie and Caitlin, and she's a lot of people that I might know. So I could go through and click on, obviously, she's a coach of mine, so I'm not going to do that because that's her brand. But, like, see how I did that? So I'm like, oh, okay, well, if this person did something, like, was interested in what I had to say, then maybe their friends will be too. And then if they like your stuff, their friends actually – see them like your stuff, so then they'll like your stuff too. That's another one. Just a matter of going out and branching out, you know, and finding more people. I mean, like I said, the biggest thing you'll run into as a new coach is one, and I do want to throw this out there because I know that there's a lot of new coaches on this team. The biggest things you're going to run into as a new coach is one, the same people are liking your stuff all the time. You're not getting any likes on your posts, or the post that you think was going to be fantastic and rule the world got nothing, right? The magic happens in the inbox. So like, just make sure that you're just going behind there, because the one thing I noticed is that my post really took off. Like, what I do have to say that just because like you don't get a ton of traction on it doesn't mean people didn't see it. They've seen it. So I think like that's the biggest thing is I noticed my post go from like 5 to 6 likes a post to what it is today by me literally getting in my inbox and just starting conversations. Because every time I start a new conversation, it's amazing how quickly they transition onto my posts. It's like that. It's so crazy. And then you can invite them because you start developing that relationship with them. Other things that new coaches are going to run into is the no's a lot, the price objections. And guys, the reason that you're dealing with this right now is because they don't trust you yet. If you're brand new, they're still working on getting to know that you're going to stick around with this. This month, this business operates on a 2 to 3 months delay. So if you send out a ton of messages tonight and you don't hear, you're like, crap, no one answered me. No one's answering my messages. And how many of you guys get that? The people that you send messages to and they never respond. A lot of you guys, right? They see you. You made that initial contact. Your job on social media is more important than ever at that point. I get so many of that. Amanda Lloyd asks, do you work on Instagram a lot? This is something that I'm slowly trying to learn. Instagram is a very, very up and coming way of connecting with people. I am really weird with the Instagram messaging system because there's a lot of creepy dudes on Instagram. So I'm having a hard time with it. But I will say that I have a bunch of, if you guys are interested in learning more about Instagram, if you feel like you found your niche and like, I know Jackie gets like a ridiculous amount of posts or likes on Instagram. I have a webinar that one of my success partners sent me about Instagram that I can pass on to you guys. So I can put that in our page tonight if you guys want it. But I do know that people are really, really excelling with Instagram. Kim says consistency with posting. People tend to like my posts more when I post at least twice a day. Absolutely. You have to show them that you're going to keep showing up. And they do want to see more of you than just Beachbody. They want to see that they can relate to you as a person. Kristen says I've actually had more likes on my Instagram posts than Facebook posts. Heck yeah, girl, utilize it. I know that a lot of people, like if you post something, like you can start conversations with all those people. You know, like think about it. It's the same thing. Like I said, my success partner, she basically runs her business off of Instagram. She'll like connect with them there and then bring them to Facebook to keep the conversation going or bring them to email. But she does the same thing. They like her post, she'll message them, and that's how it starts. Courtney said, that's where my first challenger reached out to me. Absolutely. Like Instagram is fantastic. I personally just have not really got, I'm trying to get into the stories thing. Because I feel like that's like the way of this, like it's really awesome for our business to have the story now on Instagram. I'm trying, I'm not very good at Instagram. When it comes to the business side of things, I just kind of use it to make my pictures look nice. But, I don't know how to do the whole hashtag thing, like how to track my brand. And like every time I do something, I get some nasty dude. So I'm really trying to figure it out. But I do have a webinar I can post on our page if you guys want to see it by somebody who really excels from it. Stephanie says I started a conversation on Instagram and honestly 90% of the people I have answered me on there. Yeah. If people do answer, because when you message somebody, think about it. I don't know if you guys have gotten messages on Instagram. It like actually dings your phone the same way as Messenger does. I've turned mine off because it drives me crazy. I'm telling you these people, I don't know how they get through. But again, I'm still learning. I don't want to like go too much detail on it because I'm not an expert in it. I don't know how. I'm mostly on Facebook. But it is something that I'm slowly learning, and I will continue to pass on information as we go. Does anybody have any other questions? Does everybody feel a little bit better after this call? A little less stressed? Yeah, pick your social media form that works for you. There's no right or wrong. I teach Facebook because it works for me, right? But maybe it's... That's awesome. Monica signing somebody up on Snapchat. That's freaking phenomenal. I know my friend Mackenzie Molinak, she works a lot with Snapchat too. Everybody's different. Find the one that works for you and just go with it. All right. Well, we should have a lot of exciting stuff to talk about in the next couple of days. So I really hope that everybody is feeling a little bit better. I hope that we can get off this call tonight and we can go full force and get excited. Remember, guys, that you're part of something so freaking big. Was this call helpful? I kind of just winged it. Okay. Did you guys like dancing? Should we do that every call? All right, guys. Well, thanks so much for coming on the Monday night. I know this is not a normal time. If I don't talk to you before, I know I have a lot of one-on-ones this week, but if I don't talk to you before, have a great Thanksgiving. We'll resume at our normal time next week. But we should have a lot to talk about in the next couple of days. So everybody get to work, keep your head down, be excited. This is something that, remember that feeling, you know? Remember that feeling when you're dancing. Like, that's what I want to remember. I want to remember that. So everybody have a good rest of your night and happy Thanksgiving.